You can be seated. Congratulations. Let us continue with a word of prayer. Father God, we come before you, and we do. We say, congratulations. Well done, thou good and faithful servant. Lord, we come together today and we celebrate these nurses for their hundreds, literally thousands of hours of hard work. Lord, we ask your blessings upon them. Lord, that you will continue to give them confidence and energy as they move, as they continue to work, as they move into the workforce. But now they're coming forward with more credibility and expertise. Father, we say thank you for their work, co-workers, for their families, for neighbors, for their professors, and many others that have been there to support them over these last few years. And Lord, they continue to have that support as they move forward. We ask your blessings upon this day. We celebrate this day and their accomplishments. In your name we pray, amen.
So good afternoon. It certainly is a good day to celebrate. As a coordinator of the Associate Degree Nursing Program, I have the honor of introducing the platform guest. Seated in the first chair is Reverend Jack Hankins. He is the pastor of Emmaus Methodist Church. He's provided the opening prayer and is going to be providing the benediction at the end of today's ceremony. Next is the college president, Mr. Glenn McDonald. He will be providing the congratulatory remarks today. Then we have Christine Katzberger in the third chair. She is a nursing faculty member. She's going to be explaining the history and significance of the nursing pen and read the students' name and comments as they walk across the stage to be penned. Then there's Kelly Spriggs, also one of the nursing faculty. She'll be putting the pens on the students today. I would also like to take a moment to ask the full-time faculty to stand and be recognized. And they've worked diligently. Full-time faculty, stand. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. They work very, very hard and tirelessly to provide a quality experience for our students. We also have adjunct faculty in the audience that I'd like to stand up and recognize because they are, we couldn't do the program without them. Just adjunct faculty, thank you. Also are Dr. John Griggs, who is a coordinator of the RN to BSN program, is in the audience today. Want to stand? Thank you. So for those students that are interested in getting their bachelor's degree, he's the person to see. He'd be delighted for you to pay him a visit and apply to the program. I want to also take a moment to recognize Dr. Carrie Matthews, who is here in the audience. We appreciate her oversight of all the nursing programs that we have on the main campus, as well as the Gulf Franklin campus in Port St. Joe. The nursing and programs include an 8-week certified nursing assistant program, a 1-year practical nursing program, this 2-year associate degree program, which includes an LPN to ADN bridge track, which is of students on both campuses, and our RN to BSN program. So as you can see, there are multiple entry points for students at every level who may be interested in pursuing a nursing career. And the good thing about the nursing career is you can build upon it step by step. So it's a wonderful, fabulous career. Dr. Matthews' vision for our program includes assisting students to become caring, compassionate, and competent nurses, committed to improving the quality of patient experiences of the populations we serve, and to exemplify what it means to be a nurse. I want to also take a moment to recognize Dr. Holly Keener, who's the Vice President of Academic Affairs, to stand and be recognized if she's here. Thank you. We appreciate her guidance and support she provides for the nursing programs. Also in the audience, I would like to recognize the leaders from HCA Gulf Coast Hospital. Their support's important to us. I know you're there. Up there. Okay, a couple rows. Thank you. And also, we have in our audience leaders from Ascension Bay Medical Center here. Would you like to, where are you? Over here. Thank you. Stand and be recognized. Yay. Okay, great. Great support that you provide for us, and we're very grateful. I'd like to ask Mr. McDonald to please come to the podium now for your congratulatory remarks.
Good afternoon. I just want to tell you, I love the music. that the students chose. That's really nice. And this is my first ADN graduation ceremony. I want to welcome you to Gulf Coast. This is your community's college. We're so proud that you're here. We're so proud of the students. And it has a special place in my heart. My wife is an ADN graduate. She'd love for me to tell you that it was in the early 90s. She was a great healthcare provider, and she's been the most special person in my life. I want to tell you two things today. I want you first to be proud. Be proud of what you've accomplished. It's a big deal to graduate from a college. And second, remember how hard it was to work this entire time. And take that with you the rest of your life. The most valuable thing for colleges is it teaches you how to work and commit to something. And finally, as of today, with your pinning, finish. So thank you all for being here. Thank you to the students, and congratulations.
So now is the time for the presentation of the Pinning Awards and recognition of our key recipients. So the recipients of the Pinning Awards are nominated and selected by the faculty based on the students' performance throughout our curriculum. So receiving one of these awards represents quite an accomplishment, and it is an honor for the students to receive one of these awards. So our first award is our Scholastic Achievement Award. And as I read your name and tell who the recipient is, please come to the stage to receive your certificate. So the Scholastic Achievement Award is given to the graduate who achieves the highest grade point average calculated on all courses, including the prerequisite and support courses, and all of the nursing courses throughout the curriculum. It really presents an outstanding achievement. The recipient must be committed to excellence and meet the difficult and numerous challenges presented in the nursing program. So the student who will receive this award has consistently maintained the highest level of academic success within the nursing program, with a GPA of a 3.75, yay. So the recipient of the Fall 2023 Scholastic Achievement Award is Sarah Frew. The second award is the Outstanding Student Nurse Award. This award is presented to the graduate who demonstrates a high degree of clinical expertise and professionalism during the program and in the clinical setting. According to her instructors, this student is a strong advocate for patients and classmates alike. The recipient of this award is Ms. Elizabeth Kalo. So please come to the stage. The next award is the Outstanding Leadership Award. This is given to the graduate who exhibited outstanding leadership skills, not only among the classmates, but also within the nursing profession. The student chosen for this award has demonstrated leadership abilities by assisting students in the clinical area, as well as the classroom. According to the faculty, this student is professional and respectful in every aspect. He looks out for his fellow teammates and frequently asks others if anyone needs his help. The recipient is Wade Kelly. So we do have some LPN Bridge students in this cohort. So we do have an Outstanding LPN to ADN Articulation Award. These are, we have several LPNs, all of which have done a great job. One student stands out and was selected by the faculty to receive this award. And they tell me she's proactive, displays initiative, is detail-oriented, The recipient of this award is Kristen Smith. We also have a Keys to Success students to recognize recipients. This Keys to Success is an instructor-led student recognition program for all current ADN students, and all incoming students receive an initial key during their program orientation. And after that, keys are presented to any student who earns another key by exhibiting exceptional practices and going above and beyond the expectations set within the course and program objectives. So the faculty are pleased to recognize students who have earned additional keys. So we would like to recognize and honor these students by asking them to stand at their seats. Anyone who had more than one key, please stand at your seat to be recognized. I know there's a lot of you. It's quite an honor. Okay, thank you. And thank you. After the ceremony is over, we would like the key recipients to come back to the front of the stage to have a group picture taken. Okay. So before the students receive their nursing pins, Christine Katzberger up here on stage is going to come to the podium and tell us a little bit about the history and significance of the nursing pin.
Good afternoon. So the history of the nursing pin. The nursing pin is a symbol with a rich history dating back to the Maltese cross. The Crusaders wore the cross as a symbol of service to Christianity. Over the centuries, various symbols represented service to a ruler or the community. As a result of Florence Nightingale's influence, the importance of nurses' training was recognized and hospitals began developing programs. The Nightingale School of Nursing at St. Thomas's Hospital in London designed and awarded a badge with a Maltese cross to the nurse as they completed their program. By 1916, a ceremony awarding the badges was a tradition in England and the United States. The badge symbolized educated women who were prepared to serve the health needs of society. Eventually, each school of nursing was designed and awarded a customized pin. The first pin presented to a graduating class in the United States occurred at Bellevue Hospital in New York City in 1880. The pin featured a crane in the Center for Vigilance. The center relief is encircled by a band of blue for consistency and an outer band of red for mercy and relief of suffering. The nursing pin and accompanying ceremony represents a meaningful experience for nursing students. It symbolizes the completion of educational requirements that enabled nurses to sit for the state licensure examination and then practice nursing. It is now my privilege to introduce a momentous occasion in the lives of our nursing graduates. Today we gather to celebrate the incredible journey of these nursing students whose dedication, compassion, and unwavering commitment have led them to this pivotal moment of being pinned. A symbolic ceremony that marks their tradition from diligent learners to compassionate caregivers in the profession of nursing. Please join me in recognizing these remarkable individuals as they embark on the next chapter of their transformation journey. All right, the first row can stand up and come up. Okay, Sarah Alvarez is from Miami, Florida. She would like to thank her husband, Stefan, Audrey, my baby girl, Maritza, my mother, Joe, my best friend, Isha, my other best friend, and the Lord for giving me the strength to get through every obstacle. Her plans for the future are to start in the Star RN position on 4 North as MedSurg Unit HCA, work on a nurse midwife certification, and start the BSN program at Galen University. All right, Lacey Breedlove. Lacey was born and raised in Bay County, Florida. She would like to thank her husband, who always believes in her, her kids for being patient while she earned her degree, and her favorite girls for all the study sessions and pep talks. She loves you all. Lacey is currently employed with Tender Love and Care, where she plans to continue working as an RN. Good job. Alexandra Beekner is originally... She is originally from Missouri, and she moved down to Florida 3 years ago. She would like to thank her dad for being my biggest fan and for his unconditional support of me and the life I continue to pursue. I would also like to thank my fiance for standing by my side through this experience, supporting my academic dreams, and always supporting my success in my career. I would also like to thank the rest of my family for always standing by my side through all of life's challenges. I couldn't have done this without them. She is currently employed as a nurse extern at HCA Gulf Coast Hospital and has accepted a position at BJC, which is Missouri Baptist, on the inpatient surgical unit. She will be relocating back home to continue her nursing career, to continue her education and bridge to her master's in nursing with her current bachelor's degree and associate in nursing. She hopes to advance her career as a cardiac nurse on a CVIC unit. Connie Burke. She is from Lake City, Florida. She would like to thank her husband, Charles, her children, Aaron, Sean, and Adriana. Her plans for the future are to continue working as an ER nurse at her current job, and she plans to begin classes for her BSN. Elizabeth Callow. She is from Bay County. She would like to thank everyone who supported and believed in her throughout her journey, her professors and mentors for their wisdom and guidance, her siblings, Angelina, Joe, and Alex, for their love and encouragement, friends and peers for giving her motivation to continue, and finally, her partner, Lorenzo, gave her comfort and brought her happiness when she needed it the most. She is forever grateful for all your support. Elizabeth has plans to begin the Star RN program and work in the ICU. Furthermore, she is dedicated to expanding her expertise in the field through continuing her education with the BSN program and hopefully the University of Florida for her MSN. Christina Carnero. Is from Miami, Florida. She would like to thank God, her family, her boyfriend Matt, friends, instructors, and coworkers. Christine states, I am so thankful for all of the love and support that you have shown me throughout my studies. You believed in me during tough times, pushed me to keep going, and celebrated alongside me when I achieved success. Your encouragement, advice, and help have meant the world to me. Thank you all for being there for me every step of the way. Christine plans to work in the NICU in the future at HCA Gulf Coast. Alex Cole. Alex is originally from upstate New York, but has lived in Panama City for the past 2 years. He would like to thank his family and friends. Their relentless support and encouragement are the reason he is here today. Without them, his accomplishments both in and outside of school would not have been possible. He would also like to thank his third semester group for all the laughs and for helping him get through OB. During his time in nursing school, Alex worked as a nurse extern in the ICU. Congratulations. And ER at Ascension. In October, he accepted an ICU position at a level one trauma center in Flagstaff, Arizona. He will train and work in both their trauma and cardiovascular ICU. He also plans to continue his education and earn his BSN through Capella University. Taylor Derbis. She is from Panama City. She would like to thank her parents, Thomas and Sarah. Mac and her extended family for supporting and believing in her through this journey for the past 2 years. Taylor plans on starting her career as a registered nurse in Gainesville, Florida at UF Health Shands Hospital. Chantel Fetner is from Panama City. She would like to thank her daughters, Lyra and Tavina, for their patience in looking after each other and sacrificing their weekends. She'd like to thank her mother-in-law, Phyllis, for always being there for my kiddos, and her husband for supporting our chaotic household during this process. She doesn't really know what she wants to be when she grows up, but she wants to be a good nurse. Congratulations. Amber Floyd is from Carabel, Florida. She would like to thank her daughter, Brianna Holton, for being my motivation to always be a better woman and mother. My parents, Reedy and Charlene Holton, for always supporting my determination to be a nurse, beginning as a young child. Cheryl and Trey Morrison for opening their home and family to me to lighten my travel to and from school. And most importantly, my husband, Chris Floyd, for being my rock, my savior, my biggest cheerleader, and my better half. Without you all, today would have continued to be just a dream. Her plans for the future are to continue working with special needs children at Tender Love and Care, being an advocate for children who can't speak for themselves, and serving the Bay community with care and compassion. Oh, you have to get your goodie box. Sarah Frew. They are from a military family, so she's originally from Nevada, but are now happy to call Panama City their permanent home. She'd like to thank her husband, Bob, for being her number one cheerleader, and all my family who have helped with kids and craziness so I could study. I couldn't do it without you. Her plans for the future, I will continue working locally, either in the ER where I currently work or in the ICU. Sydney Henry. Sydney is from Atlanta, Georgia. She would like to thank her parents for supporting her through the program. She would also like to thank Alex, Cole, and Emma Worth for their amazing friendship. She couldn't have made it through nursing school without them. Her plans for the future are she will be starting her nursing career as a pediatric hematology oncology nurse at Children's Healthcare of Atlanta's Cancer and Blood Disorder Center. Morgan Hutchinson, originally from Montgomery, Alabama, but she has lived in Bay County for 3 years. She would like to thank her friends and family for their constant support throughout her nursing school journey. And as a well-known artist once said, last but not least, I want to thank myself. I want to thank you for believing in me. I want to thank you for doing all this hard work. I want to thank me for having no days off. I want to thank me for never quitting. She has worked as a medical assistant for Montgomery Cardiovascular Associates for the past 9 years and plans to gain acute and critical care experience while continuing her education with the ultimate goal of becoming a cardiac nurse practitioner. Holly Johnston. Holly is from Georgia. She would like to thank God for giving her the strength and ability to successfully complete nursing school. She would like to thank her mom, Nikki, Austin, and her kids for always having her back and supporting her throughout her journey. She would like to thank Lacey and Lainey for standing by her side throughout this journey. And a special thanks to Art for supporting us. Her plans for the future, she is currently employed at Ascension Sacred Heart Bay's ED, where she plans to continue to work as an RN. Thank you. Wade Kelly is from Kennesaw, Georgia. He would like to thank Elena Sinicrope. I hope I pronounced that right. Yes? No? Perfect. And very briefly, he said he's going back in the military. Congratulations. Kayla Kessler. Is originally from Cross Plains, Tennessee, and has lived in Panama City for about 5 years. She would like to thank her family and friends for supporting her through this journey. I will be relocating back to Tennessee and would like to work in critical care. Shoshani LaFountain. Is from Amarillo, Texas, in Panama City, Florida. I would like to thank God, my husband, Jeremiah, my family, Dr. Garland, and my nurses at the Eye Center. I wish to excel in my nursing career by helping as many people as possible. She may or may not get a pen today. She did. She got her pen. Yay.
Good job.
Good job. All right, Megan Lavery. Megan is originally from Nashville, Tennessee. She would like to thank her family, which is dad, mom, granny, and Lauren, for the support and understanding of the time constraints from the program. She would like to thank friends and coworkers, all of whom listened, helped guide, and continue to mentor through this process. Her plans for the future are to enjoy every moment, have fun, and relax. Wishes to continue her path in becoming a critical care nurse, providing exceptional patient care within the community. Congratulations. Ashley Madry. Is originally from Hollywood, Florida. She would like to thank her family, friends, and Pepper for their continued love and support throughout her nursing school journey. A special thanks to my late father, Mr. Al Madry, for believing in me and encouraging me to follow my dream of becoming a nurse. I look forward to continuing making him proud as I know he's smiling down on me. Her plans for the future, she is planning to complete her BSN in the spring while serving the local community and later relocate to Dubai, United Arab Emirates.
All right now, boo-boo.
Ileana Marie Martinez Himata. Ileana was born and raised in San Antonio, Texas, and has lived in Panama City since her husband was stationed here in 2020. Ileana would like to thank her wonderful husband, Kevin, her parents, Cindy and Art, her sisters, Julia and Maddie, her girlies, and her professors for supporting her through this journey and pushing her to see it through. Her plans for the future, she currently works as a nurse intern at Ascension Sacred Heart Bay and is set to transition to a role as a registered nurse in the postpartum unit at HCA Gulf Coast. She has also aspired to advance her education by pursuing a master's degree to become a nurse practitioner in the near future. Carlos Molina. Is from Massachusetts. He would like to thank his girlfriend, Allison, his mother, the rest of my friends had my back during these times. His plans for the future will be looking forward to working in emergent care. Patricia Lane Morton. She is originally from Tampa, Florida, but she grew up in the metro Atlanta area. She moved to Panama City Beach in June 2018. She would like to thank her family, especially her sister Mary, for supporting her through this journey. Mary, you are truly amazing. She would like to thank her friends who were there for her when she thought about giving up. You kept her going. Holly and Lacey, Lainey states that she could not have made it without you. And last but not least, Art, thank you for everything. Her plans for the future are she currently works as a paramedic in the ED at Ascension Sacred Heart Bay Medical. Her plan is to be a critical care float nurse and rotate between the ER and the ICU, and she hopes one day to be able to move back to Tampa and work with the children at Tampa General. Emily Alexis Noble was born and raised in Marianna, Florida. There are way too many people to name, so I'd like to thank my family and my friends for supporting me and believing in me, for helping with the long nights of studying, for being my shoulder to cry on when things got tough, for praying for me and my classmates endlessly, and also reminding me that no matter what you were, also very proud of me. I never would have made it without you all. I love you. She currently works at Bay Medical on 4 orthosurgical and plans to start her nursing career there. She would eventually like to do something with kids, but only time will tell. Isha Patel. She's originally from Panama City Beach, Florida. She would like to thank to her family away from home, my aunt DePaula, and my uncle Brian Tania. I thank you as you've been my unwavering pillar of strength through this challenging journey. To my best friend, Sarah Alvarez, who's been a constant cheerleader and confidant since day one of nursing school. And lastly, but most importantly, I would like to thank my professors and mentors whose wisdom and guidance have led to this moment as I stand here for my pinning ceremony. I couldn't have done this without y'all. Her plans for the future are, at this moment in time, she is beyond grateful and excited to announce that she's been blessed to transitioning to working as an RN at the SICU at HCA, where I currently work as a nurse extern. Ida Peel. Was born and raised in Panama City. She would like to thank her mother, Ida Yvette Peel, her father, Jason Peel, her grandmother, Mariah, for their support in her journey in becoming a nurse. She is truly grateful to have been blessed with a family that has always cheered her on and believed in her. She could not have done it without them. Her plans for the future, she plans to start her nursing career as a postpartum nurse to care and support parents and their bundles of joy. In the future, she would like to go on to get her bachelor's and become a midwife. Ida's dream is to eventually become a master at all things baby. Summer Pridgen. Summer is from Wewahitchka. She would like to thank Alicia Smith, Austin, her mother Patchy, as well as other friends and family for their support, and she's leaving her future open to see what comes next. Congratulations. Brooke Putz is from Defuniak Springs. She would first like to thank her husband, Bradley, for being the pillar of encouragement and support throughout these 2 years. Thank you to all her parents and grandma in the unexpected ways that they have helped and sacrificed for her success. She would like to thank her 3 children for all the hugs, high fives, and good luck wishes over these last 4 semesters. And lastly, to all the teachers and students that have shaped the nurse she will become, thank you. It is an honor to have been taught by you and to work alongside you. Her plans for the future are she has been accepted to the RN to BSN program here at Gulf Coast and plans to start next spring. Olga Rinaldo is from Cuba and Miami. She would like to thank her husband, Frank, her mom and dad, and all the family and friends that made this possible. Her plans for the future are she's currently working on the cardiac floor at Ascension Sacred Heart, and I plan on continuing my education in the nursing field. Good fan club. Alicia Smith. Alicia is from Grantville, Georgia. She would like to thank my family and my friends who have been there for me throughout this journey on the way to becoming a registered nurse. Her plans for the future, she is currently employed at Select Specialty Hospital as a CNA and telemetry tech. Also, I am employed by Ascension Bay Sacred Heart as a nurse intern. She plans to pass the NCLEX and start working as a nurse. In the future, she believes that she would like to work as a nurse in the ICU or PACU. Kristen Smith is from Florida. She would like to thank her incredible husband and my precious girls for their unwavering support, love, patience, and grace. Her plans for the future are to continue supporting my community by working in acute care. Congratulations. Lauren Amanda Thrasher. Lauren lives in Bonifay. She first and foremost would like to thank her Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, all of her family, especially her mom, dad, Nana, Papa, and sister-in-law. She would also like to thank her friends, Carrie, Megan, Marley, and Sarah. Her plans for the future is she'll be working as an L&D nurse at HCA Gulf Coast Hospital. Elizabeth Paige Welch. She's lived in Panama City Beach for the last 20 years, but she considers Louisiana her home. She would first and foremost like to thank our Heavenly Father above. Without His grace, I would not be here today. My husband, Justin, and my sister, Emily, their endless support, guidance, and love has been an ultimate motivation. Her plans for the future are at this moment, she is uncertain of what the future holds, but I will always lead my practice with the quote, "The best way to find yourself is to lose yourself in the service of others." Congratulations. Luke Welch. Luke lives in Panama City. He would like to thank Mrs. Hansen for her help in OB last semester. He said she went above and beyond to help them get through OB. His goal is everyone's goal, pass the NCLEX, and he would like to work locally. Good job. Emma Worth. Emma! Originally from Long Island, New York. First, she would like to thank her amazing parents for all their encouragement and support throughout the program. She is grateful to have met and gone through the program with Sydney and Alex. She would also like to thank her boyfriend, Christopher, for standing by her through all the stress and late nights during the program. Lastly, she would like to thank her brother, Christopher, who is the reason she pursued a career in nursing. She currently works at Ascension Sacred Heart Bay as a nurse intern on the cardiac floor, and she'll be relocating to Long Island, New York, where she plans to work in cardiovascular intensive care and obtain her BSN degree. Samantha Wood. She has lived in Panama City Beach for most of her life. She would like to thank her family, especially her mom, for helping her throughout all of the years of school to get me to this graduation. She plans on completing her BSN after graduation and eventually becoming a CRNA. Christopher Zapata is from Leesburg, Georgia. He would like to thank Reagan, Mom, and Dad. He currently works as a nurse intern at Bay Medical ER, where he hopes to continue his career as a nurse. Congratulations, Reb. Julia Zapataki. Originally from Massachusetts, but has lived in the Destin area for about 14 years. She would like to thank her family, friends, and incredible boyfriend for supporting me through everything and always believing in me. Her plans for the future are to excel in her nursing career wherever it takes her.
So the students have prepared a class memories presentation for the audience to view. So we're going to dim the lights for the presentation and turn them back up for recitation of the Nightingale Pledge. And at this time, we're going to have the dignitaries on stage take a seat in the first row until the conclusion of today's ceremony. Well, that is certainly going to be a memorial experience. Okay, so now is the time the students are going to recite the Nightingale Pledge together as a group, and they're going to be led by fellow classmate Holly Johnston. So, Holly, would you like to come up?
Y'all ready? I pledge in the presence of this assembly to practice my profession faithfully. I will do all in my power to maintain and elevate the standard of my profession and will hold in confidence all personal matters committed to my keeping and all family affairs coming to my knowledge in the practice of my profession. I will devote myself to the welfare of those committed to my care.
So before the benediction, we would like to thank Holly for leading the students in the prayer, in the recitation of the Nightingale Pledge. And we would like to thank the members in the audience for attending the pinning ceremony today. I would like to ask Reverend Hankins to return to the podium, and the audience is asked to stand during the benediction and to remain standing while the students and the platform guests and faculty have exited the auditorium. Reverend.
Let us pray. Father God, we come before you and we celebrate these nurses today. We're thankful for their accomplishments. And Father, as I heard the many things read about their plans, they are looking forward. Lord, they have a great path. And I pray that you will lead and guide them. And the same people that have undergirded them in the past will be there for them in the future. Lord, I pray they'll realize that they are the hands and feet of healing that ultimately comes from you. And that they speak grace and comfort to family members and to patients throughout all of their practice. Father, I pray that you will give them hands that are hands of healing, and Lord, hearts that are hearts of compassion, and Lord, a mind, minds that are full of wisdom. And you do not give us a spirit of fear, but a power and of love and of a sound mind. We ask all these many blessings, and particularly upon this class. In your holy name we pray, amen.
I hope you never lose your sense of wonder. You get your fill to eat, but always keep that hunger. May you never take one single breath for granted. God forbid love ever leave. Choice to sit it out or dance.